Merry and blessed Christmas to you. Welcome to worship. We're all glad that you're here. Reminder that we are celebrating communion during this service. And so for those of you in the parking lot, we hope that you were sure to get your communion elements when you came to the door. And for those of you at home, this is a good time for you to get some bread or cracker or juice or water or wine.
Let us begin our worship this evening with our call to worship. In the season leading up to this night, we have been hearing the good news from all the Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, because we have needed good news, and that's what gospel actually means. We have heard stories of courage all along our journey, of people who have sung out songs of hope, love, joy, and peace. Our luminaries have been a witness to the light we believe has come and is coming. Tonight, we return to the story of Jesus' birth as it's told in the Gospel of Luke. This account is the narrative we read again and again on this holy night, for this author gives us the most beloved detail. We yearn to see the scenes play out, to hear the music of the angels, to feel the rush to the manger, to see what this star that pierces the night sky has come to proclaim. We so desire to believe the good news of the messengers, that is the culmination of humanity's pain of birth. Don't be afraid, for unto us a sign has come that will be to all people on earth peace.
Touch us, comfort us, and call us.
Even when our view is obscured by clouds of doubt, you have ignited the flame of hope, love, joy, and peace within us. Let us glow with its brilliance from the inside out. Amen.
Thank you.
time came for Mary to have her baby. She gave birth to her firstborn child, a son, wrapped him snugly and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the guest room.
Nearby shepherds were living in the fields, guarding their sheep at night, and the Lord's angel stood before them. The Lord's glory shone around them, and they were terrified. The angel said, "Don't be afraid. Look, I bring good news to you. I bring good news to all the people. Your Savior is born today in David's city. He is Christ the Lord. This is the sign for you. You will find a newborn baby, wrapped snugly and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great assembly of the heavenly forces was with the angel, praising God. They said, "Glory to God in heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors."
Thank you.
returned to heaven, the shepherds said to each other, "Let's go right now to Bethlehem and see what's happened. Let's confirm what the Lord has revealed to us." They went quickly and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger. When they saw this, they reported what they had been told about this child. Everyone who heard it was amazed at what the shepherds told them.
Thank you.
been a year to remember. Who would have thought that we would have seen and experienced all that we have seen and experienced? And it's a Christmas to remember as well. I have joked and cried a little bit with consistory as we have changed the plans over and over again for Christmas Eve for tonight. I have said to them that we are now on plan Q. We're no longer near plan B, and we've already gone through all the way to B. So tonight, here we are on plan Q. It was sad enough to imagine Christmas Eve and not being able to be in our sanctuary. And then we had hoped to be in the grove, among the lights in the grove. And then things shifted yet. Even in the grove, we normally have, in worship, we normally have 12 or 1400 members on Christmas Eve. And in the grove, we might have been able to have 200 or 300 folks if the weather had cooperated. And then the rain, the wind decided to come, blocking this part of the world from seeing the Christmas story this week, which was sad. Then sad to kind of shift gears again, to have parking lot, drive-by, worship, and online worship. But it is good to be together, even in these circumstances. And we know that in this roller coaster of decision-making is just for tonight, in the grand scheme of all that folks have gone through this year, it's not so big a loss. We know that people have lost lives and health and jobs and a lot more. And yet our loss is still real and important here as church friends and family. I found a poem that I'd like to share with you, and it's called Your Sanctuary Misses You. It's a letter written from the perspective of the sanctuary to us. I miss you a lot. I miss the organ vibrating under my floor, an anthem that tickles the ceiling. I miss being splashed with baptism, the grit of wedding rice, the weight of the casket when you let a loved one go. I miss the smell of bread, bread that's cut in small enough everyone eats pieces. I miss people leaning over the pew to say peace, or hello, or to smile at a child. I even miss prickly poinsettias and lilies that make me sneeze, and the time it rained when the animals came inside to be blessed. Puppy piddle or hot wax from those little candles? It doesn't matter. I miss you. But while you care for one another by being away, well, you know I'd exaggerate if I said that I'd actually dust the hymnals. I do promise to archive in my heart every song that you have sung, and all the voices, even the ones who only came once, or the ones who pretended to sing. The pulpit has endured preachers' spit, and watching congregations doze, but it will also store all that justice and all that comfort. Even if you remodel me one day, or put me on a flatbed and roll me down the street, and even if, God forbid, I burn down, all of the memories will be in this ground and all the sky. Some photographs to make you cry. And we will see lives changed, lots of lives changed forever. Now, before I go on too long, like a wandering sermon, or a flat note held too long, this is really a Christmas card to you. I want you to remember this. Your loving sanctuary was never the manger, or the field outside Bethlehem, or an oasis under a star. Though pageants and carols and those trippy little candles might confuse you. You see, the sanctuary, I'm just the inn, and my job is to say to you and everyone else, I am full of many good things. I am full, but go around back to the stable in your heart, and there you will find a child with Mary and Joseph and the sweet mashup of woolies, camels, and angel hosts. And that's why I miss you most. A sanctuary, a sanctuary can store a lot of hay, but you are the manger. You are the manger. Thank you, Marin Terabasi, for this poem. During this crazy time, we've been using a UCC blessing that says, be a blessing. Be a blessing. Pray often, be kind, give thanks, do good, have courage, lead with love, practice peace, be the light, work for justice, encourage others, be joyful. We've also been saying to each other to be the church wherever you are. This is a hard time, and it's a hard time not to be in our sanctuary. Our sanctuary misses us, and we miss it. And it's hard not to be together. Your pastors miss you a whole lot. And it's hard not to sing and work and be the church together in person. But the church is not closed, and the church is not a building. And we've always known God, but maybe, just maybe, one of the gifts of this time is that we will come to know that in a new way, in a deeper way, in a fuller way, in a way that helps us make sure that God's church stays alive everywhere in this time and place. You are the manger. You are the one who hosts the Christ child. You are the one who holds and nurtures the Christ child. You are the one who helps to birth this love and grace of this child into the world and among your family and friends, your church and community, and your nation and the earth. So be a blessing. Be the church. Be a manger. Today and every day.
Thank you.
Now we turn to our celebration for communion. We remember that on the night in which Jesus gave himself up for us, he took bread, gave thanks to God, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Drink from this, all of you. Do this is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me."
Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here, and on these gifts of bread and fruit of the vine. May them be for us your love and light, so that our hearts may be broken open for the world and our lives poured out in service. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world. Mix our voices in harmony with each other until we sit at the same table and sing in the same choir in your kingdom on earth as it is in heaven. Let us pray the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
The gifts of God for the people of God come for all things already. Take and eat, take and drink.
Thank you.
come to that moment of every Christmas Eve, the moment where we light our candles and sing Silent Night. We have wondered this year how we could possibly recreate a sense of normalcy in this moment. We wondered how we could get through it with joy, the joy we usually feel on this night, having lost so much this year. So no, it's not the same. And we know that because of the people we have lost, the jobs and security that we have lost, it will never be the same. Surely every year we will remember the moment when we thought perhaps light and song would elude us. But here we are. We will light our lights and we will have our song, just like those soldiers in World War I who sang across enemy lines. Everything stopped for a short while as the message that all was calm and great prevailed over the violence and dark night of the world. We have been sorely divided on many things. We are devastated by our losses. We are tired and we are not so calm. But for this moment, this night, let us remember that we are not alone, and that we believe that the music and light of God's promises come again and again. Hope for a better tomorrow, love that works for a more equitable world, joy that wells from a place deep within us, and peace that offers us the assurance we need. Please light your candles for Silent Night.
Peace and joy. Go into your lives,
humming the tunes that keep light alive in you, and tunes that spur you on in your work of justice and reconciliation. Raise your voices and repeat after me, do not be afraid.
Do not be afraid.